Hello students.
Yesterday we have started 11th lesson, that is cell structure and microorganisms. Under this we seen that is cell, that is the basic functional and the fundamental unit of a body is or a organism is the cell, and how the organ or body form from the cell, cell from cell tissue, tissues come together, it forms the organ. So many organ come together, it forms the system. Is organ system, and so many organ systems are come together and it forms a body. And afterwards we took the information of a great scientist, that is Robert Hooke. He made the first microscope. Okay, he observed the first thin section of cork under the microscope. And yesterday I told you that this is the what microscope that we are using in olden days. Okay, now moving towards the next part of our lesson, that is measurement and observation of the cell. So if you see this instrument, it is present in our library as lab also. So inside this is the microscope. Okay, and this microscope has so many parts. First it is the eyepiece. Through this eyepiece we can see the structure of cell from this slide, which is located at this place. Okay, so any slide, it may be the cell slide, or I shown you means so many slides last year. So first year eyepiece is there, from this we are observing this organism which is present in the on the slide. After that this has a focus knobs are there, fine and porous focus lab. Okay, by using this we can get the clear image of the cell, otherwise any microorganism we put inside it. Then objective lenses are there, their powers are different. By using 10-15 in this way the powers are there. By adjusting these lenses we can see the very clear image of the microorganism which is present on the slide. Here it is a stage to put the slide over it, and here is the mirror. Illuminator means only mirror. By what happens when the light falls on it, okay, it collects the mass all light and it focuses on this glass, and due to this what happens, the clear image of the organism cell we can observe under this microscope. Okay, so these are the little bit information. When you will come in school, I will show you this microscope, then you will understand it in better way. And I will show you the slides of different organisms also, funguses, viruses, and the cell slide also I will show you. So first of all, the measurement and observation of the cell. In 1673, Anton van Leeuwenhoek assembled various lenses to construct a microscope. So here in this part of the microscope, here lenses are there. Here some lenses are there. Okay, and inside also some lenses are there. And by using this what happens, we can get the clear image of the what bacteria, protozoans, cell and all. So here the lenses to construct a microscope. He was the first to observe the live bacterial and protozoan cells under this microscope. So Leeuwenhoek is there, he observed the first bacterial or protozoan under the live bacteria or protozoa he observed under the microscope. Okay, and due to this what happens, we can study the bacteria which we cannot see with our eyes. They are very minute, microscopic, we cannot see with our naked eyes, and that microorganism study is possible because of this microscope. Okay, now cells are extremely minute in size. As you know that cells are extremely minute in size, and these cells are there, we cannot see cell with our naked eyes. We cannot see with the naked eyes, open eyes, okay, without using any instrument, means naked eyes with, so this is called as a naked eye. So we can't see these cells. Micrometer, nanometer, are the units used to measuring their size. Okay, as you know that to measure the distance between the two points, okay, two places, two villages, two cities, two countries, which we are which units we are using, okay, kilometer, meter, centimeter, depends, okay, kilometer. In your notebook, if you have to measure the segment, you are using your scale, and this measurement is the cm. But to measure the size of microorganisms, that unit we are using, that is called as a micrometer or the nanometer. These units we are using to measure the size of a microorganism. Okay, the compound microscope is used for observing cell. Okay, and these measures are there. Okay, we can take by observing the organism under the compound microscope. Here in the picture, this is the compound microscope only. An object on a glass slide is magnified many times by the lens of the microscope. So the microscopic organism is there, it gets magnified by using this compound microscope. When we put slide here, by using these lenses which is present here inside it, an eyepiece, what happens, the microscopic organism becomes very, looking very huge. Actually it was very small. So how, what is the nanometer? How is the size nanometer we are measuring? So here 1 centimeter is equals to, as you know that 1 centimeter means your scale is there, this scale is there. So here it is 0, here it is 1. In between 0 to 1, how many lines are there? You know that here 9 lines are there, and 10th line is the 1's line is there. Okay, 1 centimeter. So 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. Okay, now the distance between the two points, 0 to 1, this is 1 millimeter, 0 to 1, that is 1 millimeter is equals to, means 1 millimeter is equal to 1000 micrometers. Means if we divide this 1 mm into 1000 time parts, 1000 pounds parts, then what happens, this total 1000 parts means how much, 1 millimeter. Okay, and then 1 micrometer, it is 1000 micrometer. From this one, if we divide this part into 1000 part, okay, 1000's one part is there, is equal to how much, 1000 nanometer. So how small are these units, you can understand that. Understand, from this 0 to 1, that is which is present on your scale, it's how much part we have to do, 1000 into 1000 means how much, 10 lakh parts. If we divide this part into 10 lakh part, then what happens, one part is there. That one part means nothing, but it is called as a 1 nanometer. And that much small organisms are there that we cannot see with our eyes, which are present in a water. Okay, and these organisms we can see by using this which compound microscope. Understand all of you how small it is there. So this is the measurement of this. Next it is the, they gave us one experiment. Okay, so what we have to do here, as you are taking onion, we are eating, okay, when you are taking food at that time, onion is there. So if you open the onion, you will get such a piece of a onion covering. Okay, and from this inner covering, this whitish inner cover, you can easily remove from this, and that is the membrane. It is nothing but the membrane of the onion. Okay, and that onion's membrane we have to stain it, means if we color it. And if you observe under the microscope, you can see such a type of a hexagonal shape, hexagonal cells. Cell means what I told you, small compartment under this, and these are not nothing but these are called as the cells. Okay, and these dots are there. Okay, these dark dots are there, these are the nucleus of the cell. So here what is given, just I told you what is given here. One more time we will read it. Take a piece or a segment of an onion and carefully separate the skin from its concave surface. Concave surface means inner surface. Okay, this is convex surface, and these sides we have to remove, this fine membrane or from this skin from its concave surface with the help of forceps. Okay, we have the dissection box in our school. When you will come in the school, I will show you this dissection box and this all instruments also I will say show you. So forceps means such a type of fork like structure is there, and by using these two points we can press it, then these two points come together. So this forceps, by using this forceps we have to take out the thin skin of this onion. Now place the membrane. What we have to do, place the membrane on a glass slide. Just I told you this was glass slide. Suppose this type of glass slides are there, very thin it is there, and on it we have to put what they told you and put a drop of water in it. On it we have to put one drop of water. Take that, the membrane does not get folded. That membrane is very thin actually. If you see now also open the onion and this, see, you will notice that it is very thin membrane is there. Okay, and it can folding. So we have to take care that it will not fold whenever you are mount on the slide. Now placing the slide, put a drop of a dilute solution of iodine or evosin over it and observe under 10 years. Just I told you in microscope that here downside some they have their powers according to here it is written 10x, 15x, 5x. So by using this power we can observe the images very clearly. Objective to the compound microscope, and don't forget to put a cover slip. And this is the, I'm showing you, this is suppose a glass slide, it is rectangular in shape. Afterwards we have to put here this membrane, then we have to put some one drop of water here, evosin, otherwise iodine. These are the solutions we are using to stain the slide or nucleus. We can see it very clearly. So and then afterwards we have to put cover slip on it and we have to observe under the microscope. Then what you will observe, so before placing it, okay, we have to put the microscope. In the same way, observe the cells of various parts of plant. Which parts of plant that is leaves, bark, root, tips, etc. Do you remember that last year you had observed the amoeba and paramecium that are found in the water? That are slides I think you had seen last year. Okay, same way we have to make our own slide and we have to observe under the microscope. So you will notice that these types of the structure we can see under the microscope, and this is nothing but the structure of a cell, and this is the cell. Okay, and this is dark color, it is there, it is the nucleus. This much we can see. And if you want to see more detailed structure of this, we have to use the electron microscope. It is generally present in the big research centers, are there in that places it is present. Okay, so that is about the cell. Next part is the, can you tell, are the cells that you observe all alike, all are same? Yes, structurally it is same. And structure means it has nucleus, means if you plant cells are there, they have the pentagonal structure, okay, hexagonal structure. And animal cell, it is what, round in shape. What is their structure? They are, and what are their shapes? So they have the pentagonal structure. If you see this, they have the pentagonal structure, but they are not alike. They have the nucleus, the parts are same. Okay, now collect interesting information of cells, about cell, from the reference book in the school library. For example, the largest cell, smallest cell, etc. Okay, that information they told you to collect from this. So here some of the pictures of the cells are shown. Okay, these all are the cells are there. So here there is a great variation in the shape of cell. If you see here, these all are cells only. Okay, these all are cells only, but their structures are different. Here it is amoeba, you know that it is single cell is the body. This is RBC, that is red blood cell, means our blood cells are this. How is the structure? You just observe it. Then surface cell, means on our skin, upper layer has some cells and they are looking like that. And the small hairs are also there on it. And then you can see here upper part, that is, this is the skin's upper layer. Then here it is the muscle cells are there. Okay, they are present in the muscles of our body. Here it is the bone cell. These are present in our bone. This is sperm, okay, and it is also the single cell. This is a nerve cell, means neuron, that I told you when we have some, we are getting some, we touch to the any hot object or we get hurt, then these cells are there. They are sending and receiving the information from the brain. Okay, these are called as a nerve cells. After, this is the fat cell which is present in our body. This is the egg cell. As you know that egg is there. Egg is the what? Egg is also a cell and it is a single cell. Egg is a single cell. So this is structure of egg cell and this is a spirogyra. This is also the cell. So these are the different structures of the cell. And in detail study of this all, we'll see in tomorrow's lecture. Only to understand the structure of the cell, you just notice that here what they gave you, that is there is a great variation in the shape of the cell. Their shapes are mainly related to the their functions. Observe the cell different shapes shown below. So these some of the cells from this are present in our lab. So when we will come school, I will show you these all cells. It is very interesting to observe the cells under the microscope. Okay, so today we will stop here only, and next part of the lesson we'll see in our next lecture. Okay, thank you and have a good day. And today you have to do, you have to learn this size of a micro cell, this measurement you have to read and draw the structure of this cell. Okay, so today we will stop here only. Okay, thank you and have a good day. Okay.